Mr. Singhal, I mean, coming to you, right? I mean, the dairy industry has always been a fast adopter of technology, right? I mean, compared to many other sectors. So in your opinion, what have been some of the game-changing innovations? And can you suggest any key takeaways for other industries from your experience?
No, so basically, I mean, if you look back at the dairy industry, and well, ITC has only been 3-4 years history. But if you look back the last 60 years, 65 years, when Dr. Kurian started the entire Operation Flood, I mean, and if you just compare, and it'll be very topical for all of us, in the last 70, 80 days, we've seen the pharma agitation, right? So if I look at the two parts of the agrarian economy today, I mean, one is the entire cropping, which is your wheat and rice and pulses and all. That is one agriculture. And 25% of the farmer income is basically dairy. Let's look at how these are developed over the last 60 years after Dr. Kurian started the white revolution. Because the green revolution, for the other part, 75%, started a few years before that. And what has really differentiated the both of them, and I was hearing very interestingly to the other colleagues in the panel, because you guys come from very maybe a B2B or a, let's say, technology area. But I mean, the entire growth of the entire green revolution in the area of pulses or food grains, it started from only addressing one part of the supply chain, which was basically the seed part of it, the fertilizer part of it, and the growth and the growing or the growing of the agri produce. After that, it has not addressed the supply chain. It has not addressed the reaching the customer. And that is where we fail, because we are the second largest grower of horticultural of fruits and vegetables in the country. And 40% of it gets wasted. It doesn't reach the table. It gets wasted, for example, or is not processed because of lack of, let's say, cold storage, etc., etc. Now, that is one part of it. Other part of it, let's take dairy now, which was, Rudra, your question. The dairy, I think the great service, the human service that I think Operation Flood under Dr. Kurian and NDDB has done, is that they have tried to address through technology or through problem solving the entire supply chain, right from the farmer, in terms of increasing, getting the right cattle breeding, getting the right AI, getting the right sort of fodder, getting the right milking practices, to creating infrastructure in the villages to actually buy the milk morning and day across the lakhs of villages we have, to taking it to a village collection center, to a district collection center, to the factory, and to the consumer. So that is one part of it. And that is why you see today that if you look at it, the farmer's income, average farmer in a Punjab or let's say even in Andhra, the average farmer, while he on paper gets 75% income from his agricultural produce thanks to the green revolution, gets 25% income thanks to the two cows or buffaloes he has, the variability income in the last 10 years or 20 years is much lesser in dairy than in agriculture. And that is what I think, Anirudh was talking about system thinking. I think that is what Dr. Kurian's or NDDB's or whatever system thinking has brought about, because the farmer is assured the milk prices don't go up or down like the way a tomato prices go down or onion prices go down. Governments fall, consumers cry, etc., etc. So I wanted to really bring out that context, and I hope I've been able to communicate that.